We will assume f is a one-to-one function, meaning it has an inverse function. We want to determine the function values. If f of 2 equals 5, then f inverse of 5 is equal to what output? The main thing to remember about these problems is a function and its inverse undo each other, which means if f of x is equal to y, and if we make the output of y the input into f inverse, the output will be x. Notice how these two functions undo each other because the original input was x, and the final output of the inverse function is also x. So if f of 2 equals 5, 2 is the input into f and 5 is the output. If we wanted to show this mapping, if we let this be function f, the input would be 2 and the output would be 5. And then to determine f inverse of 5, notice how the output of f is becoming the input into f inverse. Therefore, f inverse will return the original value of 2. Again, notice f and f inverse undo each other because the original input into f and the output of f inverse are the same. One more thing we should notice here, if f of 2 equals 5, f contains a point with an x coordinate of 2 and a y coordinate of 5, and if f inverse of 5 equals 2, f inverse contains the point with an x coordinate of 5 and a y coordinate of 2. Notice how the x and y coordinates have been switched, which is the reason why the graph of f and f inverse are symmetrical across the line y equals x. Looking at our second example, we have f inverse of negative 3 equals negative 2. We want to determine f of negative 2. So again, negative 3 is the input into the inverse function when the output is negative 2. And notice how now we're making negative 2 the input into f. And since these two functions undo each other, the final output will be negative 3. Again, notice how the initial input and the final output are the same. And again, this also tells us that the inverse function contains the point with an x coordinate of negative 3 and a y coordinate of negative 2. And this tells us the function contains the point with an x coordinate of negative 2 and a y coordinate of negative 3. Again, notice how the coordinates have been switched. Okay, I hope this helps.